The Lord be with you.
With thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith: Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it: Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who through thine only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, has overcome death and opened unto us the gate of everlasting life, we humbly beseech thee that, as by thy special grace preventing us, thou dost put into our minds good desires, so by the continual help of thee we may bring the same to good effect. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
Amen. The epistle is written in the 5th chapter of 1 Corinthians, beginning in the 6th verse. Know ye not that a little leaven leaveneth the whole lump? Purge out therefore the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump, as ye are unleavened. For even Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the feast, not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Here endeth the epistle.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 20th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, on the first day of the week, cometh Mary Magdalene early, when it was yet dark, unto the sepulchre, and seeth the stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, They have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid him. Peter therefore went forth, and that other disciple, and came to the sepulchre. So they ran both together, and the other disciple did outrun Peter and came first to the sepulcher. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying, yet went he not in. Then cometh Simon Peter, following him, and went into the sepulcher, and seeth the linen clothes lie, and the napkin that was about his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by itself. Then went in also that other disciple, which came first to the sepulcher, and he saw and believed. For as yet they knew not the scripture, that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciples went away again unto their own home.
Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. A homiletics professor was passing onto his students some of the secrets of a successful sermon, and this is what he said. He said, when you preach about heaven, let your face light up with joy and shine with a heavenly brilliance and a magnificent smile. And then he said, and when you talk to them about hell, your ordinary face will do. I don't know what you see in my face, but whatever my face may look like to you today, the sermon is not about hell, on the contrary, but the resurrection. The strife is over. The battle is done. That's the proclamation of this day, most assuredly. Now, Paul encourages us today to seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. We always ought to be looking up toward heaven. And yet sometimes we don't do that. Let me give you an example of what I mean about looking up and seeing the beauty of life. My grandmother had an apple tree in her backyard. And every time I visited her, I would just really like to run out there in the backyard and look at the apples. And every time I went, I'd grab some of those apples and have a feast. They were green apples, and I liked that. I liked salt and green apples when I was younger. I wouldn't take them off the ground, however. I knew better, because those had worms and bugs and junk like that, you know. They were soiled. I'd look up into the branches, and I would see the bountifulness of that apple tree, and I'd pick them right up off the tree, right there, and I'd get a big pile of it, and then I would eat those tasty, almost heavenly apples. It was a grand memory that I still have to this day. Now, in the spiritual sense, that's what Paul speaks of today also. Seek those things which are above, he says. Regarding the faith, when we're talking about things spiritual, regarding the faith, any old fool can grab worm-filled apples fallen off the tree of life, otherwise known as deadly sins. Anybody can do that, and we do that more frequently than we ought to, most assuredly. What we're talking about, however, and what we're praising God for this day, is eternity. Now, there is no higher elevation than to be lifted up into the presence of God for eternity. That's our yearning, that's our hope, that's our faith. And yet we have to work to do that. We have to be selective in our life, and we have to have good choices. And one of the glorious freedoms that we have is we have free will. But we goof it up so much of the time. We spend our time groveling in the worm-infested life that we call life in this world. Now, as we seek those things which are above, however, something extraordinary happens. If you look up long enough, you will find God. If you pray systematically enough, if you study Scripture enough, if you come and worship systematically, you will find God. Your affection will be then set on God above, not on the things of this world. It doesn't mean you won't enjoy life. Life is beautiful, and we can enjoy it. But rather, it means that things will be put into proper perspective in our life. And so when the hot dogs or T-bones or fagua doesn't taste good anymore, or the economy tanks, woo, or people do dastardly deeds to one another, or even loved ones die, and the memories of their apples or smiles or goofinesses begin to dim, even in the midst of the dark days of life, which we all have, we all experience, and things will still make sense eternally. God, whom you have come to know and to love by systematic adoration in your life, God will make all things right in the end, and you will know that. You'll know that the souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, and they are in peace. After death, resurrection. After death, new life. Therefore, we can make it through anything. How so? The strife is over. The battle is done. He is risen. He is risen. He has opened heaven's gate. We are freed from sin and its dark prison, risen with a holier state. We will see that forever and ever, eternally. Eternally. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. All things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own have we given thee.
Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice for the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling.
Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
It is very meet and right and bound a duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, thou hast caused this new light to shine in our hearts. But chiefly are we bound to praise thee for the glorious resurrection of thy Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. For he is the very Paschal Lamb which was offered for us, and hath taken away the sin of the world, who by his death hath destroyed death, and by his rising to life again has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering of the most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say,
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Deliver us, we beseech you, O Lord, from all evils past, present, and to come. The intercession of all thy saints grant peace favorably in our day. Through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee. World without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shalt come under my roof, because of the sins of the world and my soul.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Depart in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.